Vitamin D and hair loss. Could vitamin D deficiency be causing your hair loss? You might have wondered this, especially if you experience a ton of shedding and can't really explain the reason for it. Because we know that vitamin D specifically is an integral ingredient for hair health and hair loss. But how much of that is linked to hair loss is the real question. In this video, we will look at the link between hair loss and vitamin D, the factors that cause hair loss, the symptoms of vitamin D deficiency, and how to treat it. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider hitting that subscribe button as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's dive right in. First off, let's look at the link between the two. Vitamin D is metabolized in the skin by keratinocytes, and when these cells produce their keratin, which is the protein that is responsible for making the hair, skin, and nails functioning at their best, when the body does not have enough vitamin D, the keratinocytes and hair follicles run into trouble, resulting in shedding and hair loss. And as we can see in this short review, vitamin D, which we know is both a vitamin and a hormone, plays an important role in dermatology and dermatotherapeutics, due to its anti-inflammatory and immunomodulatory properties and regulation of keratinocyte differentiation and proliferation, like we mentioned. It also affects the hair cycle, and its role in hair loss is under constant research. But what about for female pattern hair loss, which is the most common cause of alopecia? This study looked at just that, with 45 women with this type of hair loss, and found a correlation between the incidence of female pattern hair loss and decreased serum levels of vitamin D3. They said it is recommended to evaluate serum D3 levels as well as other hormone assays in these patients. Why exactly? Because it's a multifactorial genetic trait. There are many factors that cause hair loss from a genetic perspective. And just because you have a correlation does not mean you have causation. And for Telogen Effluvium, which is a temporary thinning of hair on the scalp, to confirm this hypothesis, a study was conducted in serum level of vitamin D that was considerably lower in women with chronic Telogen Effluvium as well, which I thought was interesting. Let's look at some of these factors though, but before we do, let's bust some myths. You inherit hair loss from your mom's side. Shampoo causes hair loss, hair dryers lead to permanent hair loss, hats cause baldness, and swimming causes hair loss. None of these have strong studies that support them. Let's say it's not vitamin D related though, but you're experiencing a bunch of fallout in the shower. Let's say less hair in your ponytail and even more on your comb. What else could it be? Well, genetics, hormones are the main ones, but also lifestyle changes too, like a recent pregnancy, processing trauma, surgery could be some too. Also, the toxins and carcinogens and air pollution can interfere with hair stimulation as well. Then, of course, there's conditions like trichotillomania, which is an impulsive disorder in which a person pulls out their own hair, sometimes causing bleeding to the scalp. And I give a lot of credit to Amy Schumer, who was so brave enough to come out and admit she was suffering from this, which she says can hopefully help others alleviate some of their shame about it too. But let's say it's from low vitamin D. Let's talk about how to tell if you're vitamin D deficient then. The only real way is to have your vitamin D levels checked, specifically your 25-hydroxy vitamin D3 levels or your cholecalciferol levels. A normal level is between 20 and 40 nanograms per milliliter. Some experts even have a higher normal range from 30 to 50. But get this, guys, many of the symptoms of vitamin D deficiency cross over to other conditions as well, making it hard to distinguish which symptom is from what condition. So before you suspect your hair loss is from a nutritional deficiency, you want to talk to your dermatologist to get a proper diagnosis first. Because let's face it, you don't want to start treating your hair loss for the wrong cause. And if you wanted to test your D levels at home, I've left a link for an at-home kit where you can test at home if you're more comfortable that way. Let's say it is low. Does that mean it's definitely the cause? Not quite, because like I said, hair loss is multifactorial. It can be from low D as well as another problem. So what you could do is actually you could try to correct your D levels to see if it has an effect on your hair by taking 1,000 IU daily for 12 weeks while also making sure to have a well-balanced diet with enough omega-3s, iron, magnesium, selenium, zinc, and biotin to give you nutritional boosts along the way. Click the subscribe button if you found any value in this video. I'm more curious to hear from you. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.